Hello everyone, as we discussed in our last lecture or the last video of Euler equation of motion, now today we are going to discuss the topic about Bernoulli's equation for real fluid. So Bernoulli's equation from Euler equation is obtained by integrating the Euler equation of motion, that is 6.3, which is explained in the last lecture of Euler equation of motions, which is given as integration dp by rho plus integration of g with respect to z plus integration of v into dv is equal to constant. After integrating this equation, we get if the flow is incompressible, then rho is a constant, rho is the density, and then p by rho plus g into z plus v square by 2 is equal to constant, or in last p by rho g plus v square by twice g plus z is equal to constant. This is the equation number 6.4 and is known as the Bernoulli's equation, in which P by rho g is equal to pressure energy per unit weight of the fluid or pressure head. Then V square by twice g is kinetic energy per unit weight or kinetic head, and z is the potential energy per unit weight or potential head. Then next one is the assumptions of the Bernoulli's equation, and the assumptions are: number one is a fluid is ideal, means viscosity is zero. Then number two, flow is a steady. Then flow is incompressible, and last is the flow is irrotational. Then next topic is the Bernoulli's equation for real fluid. So the Bernoulli's equation was derived on the assumptions that fluid is inviscous or non-viscous and therefore frictionless. But all the real fluid are viscous, and hence they offer resistance to flow. Thus, there are always some losses in the fluid flow, and hence in the application of Bernoulli's equation, these losses have to be taken into the consideration. Thus the Bernoulli's equation for real fluid between point 1 and 2 is given as P1 by rho g plus V1 square by twice g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by twice g plus Z2 is plus HL. Here HL is the loss of energy between the point 1 and 2. So this is the equation of Bernoulli's equation for real fluid. Then another topic is the practical application of Bernoulli's equation, that is a venturimeter, orifice meter and pitot tube. So the Bernoulli's equation is applied in all problem of incompressible fluid flow where energy consideration are involved. But we shall consider its application to the following measuring devices, that is venturimeter, orifice meter and pitot tube. So venturimeter is what? It is a device used to measure the rate of flow of fluid flowing through a pipe, and it consists of short convergent part, then throat, and last one is the diverging part. You can see in the figure number 6.9, that is the figure of venturimeter. It is based on the principle of the Bernoulli's equation. Then the expression for rate of flow through the venturimeter, means this is the derivation by which we can obtain the equations. By using that equation, we can calculate the rate of flow of fluid through the venturimeter. So consider a venturimeter fitted in the horizontal pipe through which a fluid is flowing, say water, as shown in the figure 6.9. Let D1 is the diameter of at the inlet or section 1, P1 is the pressure at section 1, V1 is the velocity at section 1. Then similarly, D2, P2 and V2 are the diameter, pressure and velocity at section 2. Then A1 is the area at section 1, that is calculated by using this equation, means pi by 4 D1 square. Then applying Bernoulli's equation at section 1 and 2, we get P1 by rho g plus V1 square by twice g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by twice g plus Z2. As pipe is horizontal, hence Z1 is equal to Z2, means datum energy are equal. Then we get the equation P1 minus P2 divided by rho g plus is equal to V2 square by twice g minus V1 square by twice g. But P1 minus P2 by rho g is the difference of pressure head at section 1 and 2, and it is equal to the h, or simply small h, or P1 minus P2 by rho g is equal to h. Then put the value of h in the above equation, we get h is equal to V2 square by twice g minus V1 square by twice g. Now applying continuity equation at section 1 and 2, we get A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2, or V1 is equal to A2 V2 by A1. Then put the value of V1 in equation number 6.6, we get H is equal to V2 square by twice g minus, here is the value of, we have put the value of V1, that is in bracket A2 V2 by A1 whole square divided by twice g. After simplification, we get V2 square is equal to twice g h into A1 square by A1 square minus A2 square. So the value of V2 is equal to under root twice g h into A1 square by A1 square minus A2 square, and after simplification, we get A1 by under root A1 square minus A2 square into under root twice gh. So discharge is equal to A2, area and velocity at section 2. Then Q is equal to A2 into A1 by under root A1 square minus A2 square into under root twice gh is equal to A1 A2 into divided by the under root A1 square minus A2 square into under root twice gh. So this is the equation number 6.7. This is the equation number 6.7, means Q is equal to A1 A2 divided by under root A1 square minus A2 square into under root twice gh. This by using this equation, we can calculate the discharge under ideal condition, and also called as a theoretical discharge. So the actual discharge will be less than the theoretical discharge. Then actual discharge, how we can calculate the actual discharge, that is given by the formula, which is given as Q actual is equal to CD into A1 A2 by under root A1 square minus A2 square into under root twice GH. Here simply multiply with the CD, that is CD is the coefficient of entry meter, and its value is lesser than the 1. So here we have covered the topic Bernoulli's equation, its assumptions, and a practical application of Bernoulli's equation, in which we have seen the venturi meter. In next video, we have seen about remaining devices, or study about the remaining devices, that is orifice meter and a pitot tube. So we'll meet in next video. So thank you.